In the realm of Bretonnia, Brionne's lands are guarded by the Duke Gastille, commonly known as the Red Hand of Brionne. His armies are vast and numbers many, bearing the black and red heraldry of his namesake. Hello, and in this video we'll be painting a Bretonnian first knight on foot, in the heraldry colours of Duke Gastille to battle ready. Then we'll be adding a few extra steps and tips to take your model to the next level. The paints we'll be using are on the screen right now for our noble knight. These colours are great for all your man-at-arms and knights in your army. We also have a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use whatever brushes you feel most comfortable with. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials playlist to learn about paints and techniques. For our first knight, we'll be using Chaos Black as our undercoat, as the majority of our colours are in a darker tone. And we'll be keeping a pot of Abaddon Black to hand, just in case we make any mistakes. So let's start painting. We'll start off with the red quartering of the surcoat and shield by using Mephiston Red. We'll pick out the left side of the torso and the right lower side of the coat. This acts as our first part of the Gastille heraldry. Just a few thinned coats will be plenty to cover. Just make sure you get all parts of the quartering correct, so it matches diagonally around the whole model. For the shield, we'll mark out the quarters with a pencil before painting. Just a cross shape in the middle is all we need to start. Then we can fill in the two quarters we need, in the same style as on the knight's surcoat, top left and bottom right in red. Then we can even add this to the torso on the helmet too. That's the little bit of twisted fabric under the crest. Don't worry about being messy at this stage right now. We can clean up and paint the opposite quarters next. For the opposite quarters, we'll be using Corvus Black, filling all those areas carefully and tidy up any overspill from the red quarters. Just like before, we want a few thin coats so it covers smoothly over the undercoat. But take your time when it comes to tidying up the red. We just want to make sure that we get straight lines on the shield. But a small layer brush and a steady hand will help with this. Small, slow lines will make sure you get the control you're after, and any mistakes sorted in no time at all. If you aren't sure what needs to be in red or black for the cloth and shield, you can always check out the box art for any tips and ideas. For the small amount of tunic that we can see around his legs, we'll apply a few quick coats of Galvorback Red. This shouldn't take too long, as there is very little of this detail, but we must be careful not to get any of this colour on the surcoat we just painted. So take your time and let each coat fully dry. Now let's add some brown tones to our knightly champion. For the leather details, we'll be applying Doomball Brown to any belts, straps, boots, gloves and pouches. We can use either a small base brush or a small layer brush, depending on the size of the detail and how close it is to other areas we've painted. As this is a layer paint, we may need 2 to 3 coats, as it's slightly thinner when applying it. Once this step is finished, we can move on to our other brown colour. So we get a different tone between the leathers and the wooden side of the shield, we'll be using dryad bark for those wooden details. The size of brush can always be helpful here too, as we need to get around the shield arm and the leathers we just painted. Just be careful of those colours we applied, but we can always tidy up with the last colours we used if we make a mistake. Next, we can add a lighter spotter colour with Celestial Grey to the trim at the end of the surcoat. We want to be careful not to paint too close to the red and black cloth, but remember to paint each side of the surcoat sections. Now we have all our major areas covered, we can look at painting the metallics. For the plate armour, sword blade and shield trim, we'll be using Iron Hand Steel. This will give us a bright and clean silver for our noble knight. We want to use a small layer brush with a couple of thin coats of this colour. It may seem odd to do this so late, but there is a good reason for it, as there is actually very little of the armour on show compared to the cloth and the leather details. We just need to be careful to avoid making smudges on the leather and cloth, but we can always tidy up afterwards. And for those gilded edges, sword hilt and ornate details, we'll be using Liberator Gold. The same rules apply here too. Just like with the Iron Hand Steel, there will be as much of this colour next to other details, especially that massive eagle helmet crest. With our base coats applied, we can look at some shading. We'll start with the red details by using Berserker Bloodshade. Because we have so many details on this model, and we want to avoid making mistakes at this stage, a medium layer brush will be great to give us the control with the flow of the paint. Just make sure it doesn't pool in places, so we can apply it lightly to certain areas, especially the shield quarters. So it gives us a light shadow but doesn't drip down into the black and the steel. Just clean off your brush if it does start to pool. Next, we'll Norn oil the Iron Hand Steel, Corvus Black, Galvorback Red, Celestra Grey and both our brown colours. Just apply it lightly, as we can always add more to make some areas darker and avoid pooling or smudges on the other colours. When it comes to the Celestra Grey, we want to keep this as light as possible. And for the gold details, we'll thin down one part Agrax Earthshade with one part Larmium Medium and shade over those details. We can really focus this mix into the recesses of the crest too, so we make sure those raised details really shine. But if you think the shade is a bit too dark on those raised areas, especially on those eagle's wings, we can always touch up with some Liberator Gold afterwards. With that last shade, our first knight is now battle ready, looking noble and ready to fight for his lord. You could stop here and use the rest of these colours on your knights, or you could keep going and use these extra tips and tricks to make our knight really shine on the battlefield. Just so that red cloth and shield pops out a little bit more from those dark details, we'll add a quick and small highlight of Evil Sun's Scarlet. We'll get a point to our small layer brush by thinning our paint like normal and then twisting and rolling the brush on the palette. This brings all those bristles to point and also controls the amount of paint we apply. We want to just get those folds of the cloth and create two line edges on the shield like so. Marking out those quarters simply, but it really shows that a few highlights can really make your model stand out. And we'll be doing exactly the same technique for the black parts of the cloth and shield highlights with Eschen Grey, picking out all those folds and edges. Just keep that paint thin and that brush pointed, and this step will be super quick and looks great. Now to pick out the edges and points of the leather details with Gorthor Brown. Just by picking out the knuckles on the gloves, edges of the belt and pouches, we are adding so much character and texture to our knight. And for our last optional extra, we'll be highlighting the Iron Hand Steel and Liberator Gold with Stormhoof Silver. By adding a liberal highlight to the gold details, we can make this colour look lighter and burnished. We can also pick out the sharp edges and the lines of the armour too. We could add some battle damage here if we wanted to as well. And with these awesome extras finished, our noble first knight is looking fantastic. A whole battle formation of Gastille would be staggering to behold. We've based our knight in Stirling Mud, and if you'd like to learn more about technical paints, we have a video all about them. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel, or head to your local Warhammer store, where our amazing staff would be happy to help you. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!